You know, Gianna, I wasn't supposed to be the host. Corey Resnick was supposed to do it until we found out he actually doesn't speak English.
But don't they speak English in Australia?
Apparently not.
Yeah, I heard that they had him read the cue cards for the audition. The word was, like, fatigue. And he said something like, fat you. Anyway, hopefully our show tonight will make up for a lack of a senior dance at the pep rally.
This is what happened the last time our brains tried to get a dance together. A smoky haze fell over New Jersey yesterday, causing an air quality warning to go out across the area.
They blame the Canadian wildfires, but we all know the real cause was a Contusi family party. In sports, an epidemic of bad tattoos has plagued the football team. Many of our Mr. West Essex contestants have been affected.
Gianna, the sources told me that it's even spread to the rest of the cast. Ralphie Contusi was spotted getting this tattoo yesterday.
Joe Gittin scored his 1,000 point this year for the basketball team. That's the second player in 2 years to reach the 1,000 point milestone.
When asked about his players' continued success, Coach Lyman said, "Damn, it really took that long."
In world news, Fairfield was once again named the most Italian town in America.
To celebrate, they set fire to the snack stand at the restaurant.
Is our class president, Zach Atlas, and another random senior, Greg Ryan!
Greg, welcome to the show. You got something. What's going through your head during lockdown?
That was straight out of a movie. There was boom, and they're in the room.
Were you not scared when they put you in handcuffs?
Nah, man, they came in with AR-15s. It was like I was in a Call of Duty lobby. It was sick.
That's definitely a rational reaction to getting arrested. What did your family and friends say about the incident?
It gave me a lot of street cred. I got a lot of people coming up to me asking me for photographs and pictures.
You're telling me your parents were completely fine with it?
Nah, my parents are ops. They don't understand this. Like, you feel me?
Greg, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm definitely not feeling you. Any last words to any new fans out there?
This could have ended really differently. This was serious, so thank you to Roseland, Essex Fells, North Caldwell, and Fairfield Police. But if any of y'all here, I got a little surprise for you.
This sounds like a horrible idea.
See, I brought this water gun with me on stage. Do you want to see it?
Absolutely not. I think we've heard and seen enough from you tonight, Greg. Thanks for joining us. Greg Ryan, everybody.
Thankfully, that lockdown happened the one time I didn't have an AP exam. For a weekend update, I'm Gianna Lodato.
Welcome to Mr. West Essex 2023. My name is Zach Atlas, and I'm delighted to be your host. We have a great show prepared for you tonight. Ralph, you're even late to the bit. Come on. Ralph, you missed it. At least you're here. Tonight, the contestants will be judged on the following categories. Our two fashion runways, talents, and if we're lucky, we might even get a visit from some of West Essex's favorite teachers. I'd like to welcome our esteemed panel of judges for tonight. Mr. Greg Ashaw is a West Essex alum from Roseland, as well as a math supervisor at the high school. Oh look, who is behind Mr. Ashaw? It's Mrs. Finetti. My guess is that she's probably here to make sure no one gets snubbed like her son Vito did last year. Also with us tonight, we have one of our favorite PE teachers, Mr. Ryan Logan. Mr. Logan is a West Essex graduate, class of 2008. Don't be offended if he falls asleep during the show. He's got a baby at home. We are very excited to have you back as a judge. Our third and final judge, one of the creators of the Mr. West Essex pageant and a former art teacher here for 17 years, a big welcome back to Mrs. Amanda Procaccino. Hopefully this show meets the very high standard that you set over the last 12 shows. Thank you, judges, for taking time out of your busy schedules to be with us here tonight. Please sit back, relax, and enjoy a little bit of West Essex's finest men. By popular demand, we have added an additional runway category this year. Before we get started on our first runway category, I would like to call up Andrew Adams. Andrew was pretty adamant on not being in the show, but since the show began planning, Andrew somehow made his way into the show and into our hearts. Please welcome Andrew Adams. Andrew, did you know about the new Barbie movie coming out this summer?
In the Barbie world,
I have every Barbie that came out since 2004. My mom's given me one for every year since Christmas. What are you getting at, Zach?
Girls go party.
You're in for a real treat, you know. You definitely don't have these Barbies. You know it's all in the edition. I want to start with this. But that was always the issue of the show. But unfortunately, it didn't make it up. But we brought them back for one more. If you're interested in one of these Barbies, then no, Zach Atlas asked you to help contribute to my therapy session after the show.
I can't wait to see the new Barbies that will make their way onto my shelf, my bed.
All right, let's jump right in soon.
I definitely don't have this Barbie on my shelf.
This Barbie is going to be a menace on the dining table. Make sure you keep your daughters away from the frat basement, especially if they're from Texas. That Barbie is a major artist in dining table construction. Thank you, Josh. I'm shocked this Barbie did not make it to the big screen.
Never been more true than for our next contestant. Welcome to the stage, Coach Cox's number one prodigy, Samantha Garcia, featured at Pekin High School Barbie.
Thank you, Samantha. We wish you good luck in the next 4 years. You're going to need it.
Don't mess with this Barbie, or you will get the wooden spoon. mommy, if you're in the audience, please Venmo at Zach_Atlas_2 at least $200 for these Barbies to add to my collection.
True. Moving on. Pop culture covers lots of drama, but nothing grabs our audience quite like celebrity couples. What's the latest you got from here?
Alright, Zach. Inside sources tell me NFL quarterback Josh Allen, actor, songwriter, and Samuel have developed a new love interest. The two have been spotted on multiple occasions catching a quick fight. Keep an eye out for this one, ladies and gents.
Thanks for the update, Drew. But now, let's cover the hottest couples around and meet the celebrity couples of West Essex. Our first contestants are back for one night only, Tom Brady and Giselle. He may have 7 rings, but he'd really love to get his 8th back. It's okay, Tom. Brock will always be there for you.
Tom's getting tired of kissing his kids. He wants his lady back.
Thanks, Josh Golden. Clap my hands when the band left it like the black folk.
So not only do I have to deal with this at school, I have to deal with this at my family functions. Love you, cuz. Bro, The Sopranos was the best show that ever hit the screen. Do you know David Chase, the creator of The Sopranos that went to West Essex?
Yeah, they filmed it right here in North Caldwell.
Please welcome the first couple of New Jersey, not Governor Murphy and his wife, Tony and Carmela Soprano. Who knew there was so much money in waste management? Wonder if there's still some cash in the bird.
Yeah, I can definitely use some cash for the weekend. Let's go after the show, please. Thank you, Luca. Is it good be bad, or bad be good? This couple, straight from the depths of hell, lies the devil himself, Anthony Scarpa, joined with the angel from heaven, TJ Seppi. Check the label in heaven, it's TJ Seppi. Thank you, TJ Scarpa.
Nah,
God, Jack, I've been locked down for years with the same girl.
Well, here we have Ben Affleck and Jennifer Lopez. After saving the streets of Gotham, Ben saved Jen from home run hitter and former New York Yankees Alex Rodriguez, yet he still seems miserable in every picture.
Let me tell you, Zach, I got a hot take. Ben Affleck is a top-tier Batman, debatably number one.
I disagree.
I cried at that scene. It's really touching. But I'm still not giving away my Barbie, so Mom, don't even think about donating.
That concludes our two runway categories. Let's take it to the crowd, Drew, and see who the audience was liking the most. Who had a favorite couple? Brooke? Does anyone have a favorite couple here? Jesse. We have an exclusive over here with Jesse. How do you like being featured in the show? True. I don't think she liked it. Anyone else? Who had a favorite couple? Anyone? Can't see any. Favorite couple? Give us your favorite couple.
Going with Sammy's performance of Jesse and Pharaoh.
I like that one. I like that one. Cool. Ow. You guys don't even know here, bro. Answer for me.
I'm going to say Liv Moyes and Vin Riera.
Liv Moyes is not even the show. Thank you guys for participating. We very much appreciate it. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's the moment you've all been waiting for. We are about to begin the talent portion of the evening. Over the years, we've seen everything from the Blue Man Group to the Dirty Dancing. There's your greatest scenes from stage and screen and some very original talents. First up, we have Josh Malmsteen doing a popular skit from SNL. Take it away, Josh.
Okay, Josh, you ready? You read me your top three goals for this year, and I'll read pants, pee in the cup. Carol Lucy's in the house and she will fix you up with Jenna. That's the worst. Fever's rising.
Take some ice. Who's that knack on top of
me? It's me! It's me!
I said, who's that knack on top of
me? It's me! It's me!
Woo! Go with more!
Shut up! Are you serious? An esports tournament!
But Tom, your kills are just insane. I'm so jealous.
Would you please shut up? We don't need validation from two loser cheerleaders. Us esports kids are gonna rule the school one day.
Whichever you want is your rule.
Mark my words, I'll be a billionaire. So I don't wanna be infected by your loser journey.
Come on, Tom, you're straight for the esports team's my biggest
accomplishment
in life. You know I don't do much.
Josh, I'm not so sure about kicking your butt, so shut up. Yeah, shut up.
This stinks. Tommy is so mad at us.
I wasn't trying to make him happy. He's literally my hero.
Oh, I know what he wants. The perfect cheer! We want to level up, Tommy, to win. We want to level up, Tommy, to win. School game esports, all of their money, even field hockey went home, crying to mommy.
just beautiful. Next up, we have the Italian Stallions of Luca Salvatoriello, and I can't wait to see this one.
So good to see you. Good to see you. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very sorry, but our performer Frankie Valli tonight is not going to be able to make it to perform. I know, I'm so sorry. But maybe, Mr. Luca Salvatoriello, would you be able to sing for us and perform for our crowd tonight? Come on, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it. Who would like to hear Luca Salvatoriello?
I'm not sure. I'm not even prepared. I don't even think I can.
But you sing.
To be taken, yeah, you're tired of me.
reckless stars make you drool just like pasta. When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, when you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, senor. Excuse me, but you see back at old Napoli, that's a mole. It's up to you, New York, New York, New York, New York.
I knew this guy could tackle a quarterback, but who knew this guy could tackle Frank Sinatra and Dean Martin? Great job, Luca. Next up, we have Tommy Amabile, who's ready to bring back a popular dance game that some of you may remember. Good luck, Tommy.
two complete. Player through. Player one. Ready. Here we go.
Tommy, I hope you bring that same energy to the dance floor tomorrow at ball. Here comes a contestant that you managed to get on TV. This guy is looking for love in all the wrong places. Let's see if he can find it on the Mr. West Essex stage tonight. Welcome, Ralphie Contuzzi.
I have brown hair, brown eyes, and a Hawaiian shirt. Today I'm speak to?
I would go to the door that says after you cry.
I wasn't crying, I was cutting onions.
I'm the guy that plays D1 lacrosse and knows his way around a lacrosse stick.
That's horrible.
I like this.
Me too.
Thanks for our date this afternoon at Yankee Stadium. Sorry you got hit in the face with the ground ball, but luckily, when I was coaching first base, I almost got hit, but I got out of the way.
It's okay, I just wanted to see how tough I am. I did it on purpose. Me too.
I love dinner last night at 3:30, smoking in Fairfield Park, smoking a cigar.
I think I'm in love.
Excuse me. I like this.
I don't.
Do you want to hang out for the ball round?
Not really.
You're cute and fun. And do you like sports?
Yeah, they're all right. No, you're here to see me, not my dad.
Can I feel him? I like this.
Me too.
I wanted to tell you something last night on our date. I have 16 grandchildren. I can't wait for you to be their granddaddy.
It's okay, I like acting like a granddad, and your grandkids call me Big Poppy. Well, we don't have much in common, but I hate to see you go, but I guess you might have to.
Okay, I'll stay. Can I steal him? I like this. I love that we can laugh together, but I had a really bad meal before this.
That's disgusting. Me too.
There's one more thing I forgot to tell you last night on our date. Everyone I know is dead.
That's depressing. I don't know how to respond to that.
Thank you for sharing, Mildred. We really appreciated that fact. Before we announce our winner tonight, we have a few words from our sponsors. First, from Zest and Century 21 Realty, who definitely paid a lot of money to have Ralphie Gattuzzi, their son, in the show tonight. Despite the age difference, I'm glad he found love, and I hope it lasts as long as Mildred's age. Speaking of happy couples, let's welcome our next super couple and see what kind of talent they have. We're the Mario Brothers. Plumbing's our game. We're not like the others. Get all the fame. You think it's in the home? Coca-Cola's on the double. We're faster than the others. You'll be hooked on the brothers.
Great job, Max. Way to use two of your favorite things in your skit, wrestling and Alexa. We won't tell her which one you said is your real favorite. Next up, we have the newest YouTube sensations taking to the West Essex hallways and going viral about what little they know about rock and roll. Don't worry, Miss Kinsey, it's not that kind of viral.
It's TJ. You know, there's so many questions on our minds these days, like, will I be successful?
Will I get a job after I graduate?
Will the country always be divided?
Will my civil rights still be at stake?
Will seniors ever be allowed to play senior assassins again? Who knows?
Well, it doesn't matter. So, we're going to the halls of West Essex, and we're going to be asking kids and seeing kids
We're gonna ask them if they could name the songs of the bands on their t-shirts. You ready, Spay? Let's go.
Yes, I am.
What's your name?
My name's Ryan Pierce.
Matt.
Okay, where are you guys from?
Fairfield.
Fairfield.
Oh, cool. Okay, do you know who we are?
No idea.
No clue.
Bro, what? Alright. Whatever. Alright, so I see you like rock. So my friend Espeo here, he has a $100 bill. And if you can name the song that we play for you, then you'll win it. Sounds good?
Yeah.
Alright, let's go.
Now and then when I see her face, she
Once again, Guns N' Roses, that's not even close at all. Get out of my face. I don't want to see that anymore. Please go. Walk by yourself at home. I don't... Good night. Go to sleep. All right. Whatever. All right. Now you, come here. Yeah. Oh. So. What's your name? I don't care. Okay, where are you from? I don't care about that either. All right. But at least I see that you like, you know, rock, right?
Yeah.
All right. Once again, I have a $20 bill in my hand. And if you can name this rock song, I'll give it to you. All right?
Okay, perfect.
Okay, good.
Thank you.
Show of hands. How many of you own a rock t-shirt but have no idea what song the band sings? Who's on the shirt? I can't see, but I'm sure a lot of you raise your hand. Seems like there may be more than we thought. Let's ask the audience who their favorite rock artist is. Mr. Logan, you got an answer for us?
Yeah, Nirvana, man. Always.
It's a good one. What's your favorite song?
Smells Like Teen Spirit.
Any other parents who want to answer? Parents? Anyone? Dad?
Tom Petty.
What's your favorite Tom Petty song?
Free Fallin'.
All right, I think we have to switch it to some of the kids. Frankie, who's your favorite rock artist?
I don't like rock.
What do you want then?
Rihanna?
Thank you.
our talent portion of the show. What entertaining performances. It's not every year we have two administrators guest appearing in the show. This is a tough decision for the judges. All these acts were amazing. Let's give a big round of applause for all the talents these guys brought to the stage tonight. As Mr. West Essex heads into its 13th year, let's take a walk down memory lane and look back at our winners. In 2009, Mamadou Niang stole the hearts of the crowd with his rendition of Barbie Girl. Mamadou went on to study and run track at the University of Maryland. In 2010, Pete Dell wowed the judges with his guest stand. Pete went on to study and play lacrosse at Manhattan College and is now living in New York City. In 2011, it was Dan Gautieri with his amazing evolution of dancer team. Dan went to UPenn to play baseball. In 2012, Stephen O'Neill performed a side-splitting Disney song with a friend. Stephen graduated from Princeton University and is now married to his high school sweetheart. In 2013, Eric Marr played the accordion and sang the song Call Me Maybe in German. Eric went on to study at Rice University, where he ran track and is now a teacher. In 2014, Greg Contaldi did the Irish River Dance. Greg attended NYU and is now a producer at the Drew Barrymore Show. In 2015, Chris Castro led an iconic lift with his partner during his Dirty Dancing routine. In 2016, Alberto Gonzalez put on a Broadway cabaret performance of You're the One That I Want from Greece. He is now a dentist. In 2017, Liam Falls stole the show with his over-the-top energy in all the categories. Liam was a track athlete at Emory University in Georgia, studying biology and pre-med. He has hopes to take over the family allergy business. In 2018, for the 10th annual year, we added girls to the show. Alexa Artali and Anthony Sangelo were crowned the winners with their Broadway hit that we still can't get out of our heads. They call me Sange, and I like it. In 2019, Tommy Egan blew us away with his paint-splashing blue and green performance. He majored in chemical engineering at CCNJ and played rugby during his time there. In 2020 and 2021, well, you know what happened. In 2022, Paul Gustafson took to the stage with Buda Fanetti to go against each other in a lip-sync battle, but it was his impression of Mr. Glenn that everybody remembers and stole the judges' hearts. Paul's currently attending Seton Hall University. Brought back by popular demand, we have some of our favorite teachers playing one of our favorite games. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome your favorite host and the voice of Mr. West Essex, Mr. Pat McGlynn.
Now, without further ado, let's meet our contestants. Our first team is fucking.
Let's see what's up there. Show us leaving after AP exams.
Nope.
Okay, number 7 answer on the board. Nice job. All right, we go over to Ms. Westervelt. Same question. We surveyed this 100 students. Top 5 answers remain on the board. What are the most ridiculous school rules?
Only seniors can park on campus.
Only seniors can park on campus. My juniors would have me believe something different, but show us senior parking. All right, number 4 answered on the board. Nice job, senior parking. So, we go over to Ms. Hobie. Ms. Hobie, same question. We surveyed 100 staff and students. What is the most ridiculous school rules?
Not being able to wear hats or hoods in school.
Right, Norma!
No hats, no hoods in school. I like it, something like that. Let's see, hats and hoods. All right, number 3 answer on the board. All right, Mr. Majocchi, same question.
My wife, hands down, she's the hottest.
All right, sorry. You did not take a call. We switched up. We switched questions up. So, we're not doing that category anymore, but we did survey 100 staff and students. What are the most ridiculous school rules?
We should play music in the hallway so we could do this.
All right, let's see. Music in the hallways, maybe during passing time? Nope, okay, there's our first X on the board. All right, so touchable, crossable, start to think of a steal. We have 3 answers remaining on the board. We go back to Mr. Davis. Mr. Davis, what are the most ridiculous school rules?
Locking the bathrooms.
Locking the bathrooms. Yeah, we have to funnel into the cafeteria. The kids don't like that. Show us locking the bathrooms. All right, number 5 answer on the board. If you guys didn't mess them up, we wouldn't lock them. But all right, let's see. Same question goes back to Mr. Gilberto. We surveyed 100 staff and students. Top 2 answers remain on the board. Only 1 strike. What are the most ridiculous school rules?
My students need to take mandatory midterms and finals.
Yes, we did bring back finals this year to West Essex, and all the kids just love it. Show us midterms and finals. Okay, number 6 answer on the board. So we've got 1 answer remaining, the number 1 answer on the board. We have 2 strikes left, touchable, crustable. Start to think of that steal. We're over here with Miss Hobie. Sorry, Miss Westervelt. I don't want to skip you. Here we go, Miss Westervelt. We surveyed 100 staff and students. What are the most ridiculous school rules?
Phone jail.
Phone jail, another new rule this year. Let's see if it's up there. Show me phone jail. Oh, okay, 2nd X on the board. I guess it doesn't count as a rule if we don't enforce it. All right. So, our most ridiculous school rules, once again, this summer we surveyed 100 staff and students. What do you got for me? We've got the number 1 answer on the board. Touchable, crustables, there's 2 strikes. Miss Hobie, what is the most ridiculous school rule?
You give me a second.
Our attendance policy.
The attendance policy. That's right. No more difference between excused and unexcused. Let's see if it's up there. Show us attendance policy. Oh, no answer on the board. All right. So the phone police have taken round 1. You guys get the full 100 points. But we are moving on to round 2. We're going to play for double the points. So let's get the next 2 contestants up here. We have Chef Rob and Mr. DiLiberto. That potassium going. It's been a long night. All right, we surveyed 100 staff and students. Top 4 answers are on the board. What are the top things that kids do for senior service? I hate my life. All right. Mr. Gilberto, you came in first then. What do you got?
Working in elementary school.
Working in elementary schools. We certainly do send the kids to elementary school. Let's see if it's up there. Elementary school. Nope, okay, strike. So, Chef Rob, if you can give me one of the answers on the board, you guys can take control of the board. We surveyed 100 staff and students. What are the top things kids do for senior service?
Probably baking at the food pantry.
Baking at the food pantry. Show me baking at the food pantry. Oh, number 3 answer on the board. Okay. Chef Rob, you got Chef Rob. Chef Rob, I take it you're going to play. All right. Touchable crustables are going to play. Phone police, think of a steal. All right, so we go over here to Mr. Mahoney. Mr. Mahoney, we surveyed 100 staff and students. What are the things that students do for senior service?
Read interesting and nuanced novels at local libraries.
Sending kids to the library. I've sent a kid or two there. Let's see the library. Nope, okay, first X on the board. All right, Mr. Logan, our alumni, Mr. Logan. We surveyed 100 staff and students. Name things kids do for senior service.
Hey, Humbeck, shout out to the baseball team, Humbeck. You know, we didn't have anyone else here, but I got my car washed by the Give Kids the World last week. Gotta give it to them, right there.
All right, let's see if it's up there. Give Kids the World. All right, number four answer on the board. Fun police, get that steal ready. You guys have one strike. One strike on the board. All right, we go over to Mr. Morgan. Mr. Morgan, we surveyed 100 staff and students. Name the things that kids do for senior service.
That's tough. Stringing lax sticks, man.
Stringing lax sticks, all right. That certainly would take some time. Show us Lax Bros, stringing lax sticks. All right, second strike on the board, okay. We go back up to the top here for Mr. Zamaya. Mr. Zamaya, you have two strikes on the board and two answers, the top two answers remaining. We surveyed 100 staff and students. Name things that students do for senior service.
Work at an office.
Working at an office. We do encourage internships. Show us working in an office. All right, number two answer on the board, working with your parents. That's a no-no. All right. So, Chef Rob, two strikes on the board, the number one answer remaining on the board. We surveyed 100 staff and students. Name the things that students do for senior service.
I'm a little new here, so I got nothing.
All right, buddy, you gotta give me some answer.
I got nothing.
All right, well, I'm one of the co-coordinators of senior service. I know for a fact that our kids are doing something, but go ahead, show us nothing. Nope, okay, look at that. Number one answer on the board. Sorry, phone police. Okay, so the touchable crustables, so many things wrong with that, have taken control of the board here, 190 points to 100, but we are entering the third round where you can get triple the points. So I'm going to need my next contestants down here on the board. Let's get Mr. Mahoney and Ms. Westerveld. Okay, once again, just remember, you can't buzz in until I complete the question. We surveyed 100 staff and students. Again, this round is for triple the points. Top five answers on the board. What is the climate and culture of West Essex? Okay, Ms. Westerveld, you were in first.
Friendly morning greetings at the door.
Friendly morning greetings at the door. There's always a smile from administration. Show us friendly greetings. Oh, number four answer on the board. Okay. Now, Mr. Mahoney, if you can give me one of the top three, you guys can get control of the board. I'm going to give you the question again. We surveyed 100 staff and students. What is the climate and culture of West Essex?
Being the undisputed valedictorian and getting into multiple prestigious Ivy League universities.
Okay. We love our Ivy League schools here at West Essex. Show us the Ivy League. Oh, okay. That's an edge. All right. Touchable crustables. Think of that steal. Ms. Westerveld, do you want to pass or play?
We're going to play.
All right, you're gonna play. Fun police are gonna play. All right, Miss Hobie, it's going to you. We surveyed 100 staff and students. What is the climate and culture of West Essex?
Beating Caldwell.
Beating Caldwell. All right, let's see. We'll see if it's up there. Beating Caldwell. Okay, first X on the board. All right, so touchable crustables. Start to think of that steal. Next up we have Mr. Michocci. Mr. Michocci, we surveyed 100 staff and students. What is the climate and culture of West Essex?
Snow days.
Snow, you realize you haven't called a snow day in like 3 years, but we'll check it out. Show us snow days. Oh, okay, second X on the board. We go back to Mr. Davis, touchable crustables, get that steel ready. We still have five answers on the board, Mr. Davis. So, we surveyed 100 staff and students. What is the climate and culture of West Essex?
That's easy. Safety and security.
Safety and security, a staple of Mr. Davis's day. Show us safety and security. Oh, man, okay, safety and security is up there. Mr. Davis, we know you're the glue that holds this place together, all right? All right, on to Mr. DiLiberto. Mr. DiLiberto, we serving 100 staff and students. What is the climate and culture of West Essex?
You know, in the fall, every Friday night at 7 p.m., I go and see my Marching Nuts play at Travis Field. Give me the Marching Nuts.
You mean the football halftime show?
Football team?
All right. Show us Marching Nuts. All right, number five answer on the board. Westervelt. And Ms. Westervelt, we have our top, we still have three answers remaining on the board. We surveyed 100 staff and students. What is the culture and climate of West Essex?
Giving students a voice.
Giving students a voice. All right, we have two strikes on the board. Touchable crucibles, I hope you're thinking of a steal. Show us giving students a voice. Oh, okay, all right, third strike up on the board. So touchable crustables, you guys have a chance to steal. You guys can still win. Fun police, keep it together. We can still win. All right, touchable crustables, who am I going to here? Let's see, I was right over here, Mr. Logan. At least he's paying attention. All right, Mr. Logan, we serve both our staff and students. What is the climate and culture of West Essex?
High academic standards.
High academic standards. All right, remember, if you guys get this, it's going to be the game. If not, the fun police are going to take home a win. For the win, show us high academic standards. Number one answer on the board. Okay, crowd. We still have two answers remaining on the board. What do we have? Any suggestions there for what number three and number six could be? What is the climate and culture of West Essex? Any responses? Anybody in the front row? What do we got? All right, well, show us number six. Mullets. Okay, all right. Hopefully that'll be gone soon. And show us number three. Early dismissals. Okay, all right. Well, that's all the time we have. That's all the time we have for today. I'm sorry, Miss Obi. We'll have to get you next year. But congratulations to the Touchable Crossables on their win. Hope you guys realize that none of you are tenured and you went up against the administration. But all right, and that's all the time we have for tonight. Thank you for playing another edition of West Essex, Mr. West Essex Family Feud.
Well, there you go. Before we hear the winner of tonight's show, we want to take this opportunity to thank a bunch of people that made this show possible. First, thank you to the administration, board members, and faculty that support Mr. West Essex. This show is a fundraiser for the senior class that gives the money directly back into the class. Specific thanks to Mr. Machocci and Mr. DiLiberto for taking time out of their schedules to rehearse with our contestants. Thank you to the teachers that allowed us to impersonate you. Clap again. Thank you to our custodial staff for always helping set up and break down and being on call. Now we're getting hanging this. Thank you to Trey Wakashima. Thank you to the stage and tech crew, Gianna Madonna on sound, Aaron Izaki on mics, Sophia McGann on Sophie Lahu on spotlights, Aiden Walker, Brandon Cunningham, and Christian Ragusa backstage. Thank you to Mrs. Lascotta and Aaliyah Crate for your help with the scenes, especially in Max's act. Thank you to Chloe Bodyguy for your help with our singing. Finally, thank you to the dance team members. And now, Mike McAlone would like to say a few words. Come on, Mike.
On behalf of the contestants, I want to thank the producers of the show. Despite thinking we do nothing for senior service, I don't think we've ever worked harder on something in our lives, and to be able to give back to the senior class, we are really proud of this show. First, thank you to Bella Pereca and Alexa Agassin for pushing us beyond our limits dancing, because we're pretty bad. Thank you specifically to the Essex Dance Academy for allowing us to use our studio. Thank you to Gianna Lodato and Zach Atlas for producing the show. Gianna, thank you for not only if Mondo said that this is the... Thank you for working as hard as you did, because Mondo said that this is the hardest kids have ever worked on a show. The amount of hours you put into making the show happen didn't go unnoticed, and we are eternally grateful for your support, time, and effort. A special thank you to Mr. Walsh, Ms. McDonough, and Ms. Colabelli for your help. We want to thank Mr. McGlynn and Ms. Fernicola, along with a very special thank you to Mondo. Let's wait for Mondo. I mean, we're not a show without him. We want to thank them for making this possible. The teamwork that went on in producing the show and the amount of hours you put in, it gets better and better each year, and we are very thankful for that. And last but not least, we want to thank you all so much for coming to our show tonight and supporting the class of 2023.
Okay, guys, the judges are still tallying up their votes, so I want one more round of applause for all nine of our contestants tonight. You guys ready? Ready? All right, I'll bring the mic to you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. If I knew I was going to be standing in front of you, I would have dressed a little bit nicer. But these are also the nicest clothes that I own. Tonight was a truly standout performance for us as judges. All the talents, I think, elevated Mr. West Essex to the next level. So every gentleman up there and all of your accompanying men and women who helped you should be very proud of themselves because they did a great job. Let's hear it for everybody one more time before we ask our winners. I'm happy to report that this evening there was a unanimous decision that did not require any, let's say, controversial math, as I am accused of last time. But in any case, in this particular case, we are proud to announce third place, the second runner-up, Mr. Vincent Ramiro. In second place, our first runner-up, the only thing more broken than his dancing, will be his heart, Tommy Abigail. And we are proud to crown tonight's Mr. West Essex, who demonstrated that he is, in fact, a superstar. Congratulations to Mr. Michael Maglione.
Thank you. to come back.